I want to take you through a few different plants that you can grow in these systems, and I want to talk about rotation length, resource demands, value, and ease of growing. So first I'll start with leafy greens and herbs. They're really easy to grow in these systems. They have a short rotation length, they have a high value, and they have low resource demands. So leafy greens and herbs are very, very well suited for an aquaponic system in general, and they work very well in this mini aquaponic system. Fruits and berries are a pretty easy plant to grow. They do have some resource demands. They're relatively shorter rotation length, and they can be high value. Other plants that we want to look at would be high value vegetables like tomatoes and peppers and cucumbers. Sugar snap peas, they have sort of a longer rotation length with a bit higher value. They do have a high resource demand, but they're fairly easy to grow. Flowers are another thing that you can grow in these systems. So if you wanted to grow roses or nasturtiums or some sort of other flower year round, you can have those in these systems. They're sort of a medium rotation length crop. They do have some higher resource demands in terms of potassium and those sorts of things. And they're only sort of a medium difficulty to grow. Other plants that you might look at would be some of the lower value grains and larger fruits and vegetable type crops. So like I said, they have longer rotation length. They require a lot more resources and able to grow those. The value is relatively low. The value of these crops are both in terms of what the market price is. And the fact that you can grow these plants indoors year-round would allow you to be able to recapture some of the expenses of this system for producing it for yourself rather than going to the grocery store and buying a similar product that's fresh. So you can have a locally produced product that doesn't have to be shipped in from, you know, Mexico or South America. You'd be able to produce it yourself and be able to have a really good, high-quality crop come out of these systems. Another issue these days is that less and less people know how to garden. They don't know how to grow plants that much. So growing plants in a system like this, you're able to teach young people how to be self-sufficient and also some of these natural processes and how they work and be more connected to their food. So in terms of leafy greens, we're looking at things like lettuce and basil, cilantro, kale, other types of leafy green crops that you can eat. If you're looking at fruits and berries, strawberries do really well in these types of systems. You might look at something like raspberries. You could even grow watermelons and larger crops like that, but it takes a lot of space and resources to grow those. But in terms of some of those lower value, higher resource crops, things to avoid would be things like corn or soybeans, wheat, those sorts of things. Potatoes you can grow in here, but there's not a whole lot of space for those to grow. Other types of rooting crops like carrots you can certainly do in a system like this. I've seen it done. Maybe not quite as valuable. And trees for fruit or nut production, they can certainly be done, but like I said, this system's not suited very well for those types of plants. So now that you know what kind of plants will work well in this system, I encourage you to go to your farm store, find some seeds, pick them out, plop them in your system, see how they grow. And read it again up against our color chart here to find out what concentration of ammonia is. So that's total ammonia nitrogen.